हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ जया करवल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर पॉलिटिकल साइंस फ्रॉम SPCGCE अजमेर, एंड दिस इज बीए पार्ट वन पेपर सेकंड रिप्रेजेंटेटिव इंडियन पॉलिटिकल थिंकर। अर्लियर वी हैव कवर्ड सो मैनी टॉपिक्स और पॉलिटिकल आइडियाज ऑफ इंडियन पॉलिटिकल थिंकर्स and their political views, and in this video we are going to study about Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and his idea of Panchsheel, and as we have talked about it earlier in our previous video that he was nationalist as well as internationalist, and Panchsheel that indicates his ideas also his support of internationalism. So let's start. There were three considerations behind his policy of non-alignment. First one is India as a newly emergent nation state had to concentrate on economic and social reconstruction. Second one is India was a country of Buddha and Gandhi, a country of peace and never an expansionist. And third one is it is supported by the circumstances of that time, that is international power politics. So we all know that Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru adopted the policy of non-alignment along with the other top leaders of the developing or underdeveloped or at that time those countries who used to be there, and along with their support with their support he supported the policy of non-alignment, and or he supported the non-alignment movement. And here we are talking about the circumstances of that time in India or the condition of India at the on the world map. We can see here that first one was that as India got independence at that time, so the economic and social reconstruction, which was the basic necessity of for India. And second one is our history, our enriched history, that is we have so many ideas, or we have ideals, and Buddha and Gandhiji, and India along with this has been a country of peace, and India never supported either dictatorship or imperialism or expansionist ideas which have been prevailed in so many countries. And in today's scenario also we can see some countries supporting this theory, but India never supported it. And third one is circumstances of that time when international power politics was there, as we all know that USA and USSR at that time when India got freedom, and the world was divided in two power blocks, and the leader of first power block was USA, and second one was and leadership was there of USSR, and therefore India adopted the policy of non-alignment movement because of all these reasons or causes. And Nehru believed in reconciliating approach to international relations. And in June 1954 the fundamental tenets of the Panchsheel were laid down in the joint declaration by Nehru and Chow En Lai. Nehru India, that is India, and Chow En Lai, that is China. And under their leadership, under the leadership of Nehru and Chow En Lai, the world saw the tenets or principles of Panshin first time, although it was not new to India, but it was the first time when world supported the theory of Panchsheel, and here we can see the Panchsheel. These are mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. Second one is non-aggression. Third one is non-interference in each other's internal affairs. Fourth one is equality and mutual advantage, and next one is peaceful coexistence and economic cooperation. And these were further reiterated in the joint declaration of Nehru and Tito and Nasir on December 22nd, 1954 and July 19, 1956 respectively. And it suited according to him most of the present times when nuclear weapons have more or less been outlawed, and the solution of problems through war. It was India's responsibility as a member of the human family to advocate such course of action. Live and let live. Panchsheel was a kind of mental approach followed by political and economic policies appropriate to it, and it was to solve many Indian problems. Democracy and socialism cannot survive unless the world is saved from the war. And he was no more a saint, but he tried to apply Gandhian methods in the arena of international रिलेशंस. पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू के राजनीतिक विचारों के अंतर्गत आज हम लोग पंचशील के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, जो कि 1954 में 1954 में अपनाए गए थे. पंचशील के जो फंडामेंटल टेनेट्स हैं, सिद्धांत हैं, मौलिक सिद्धांत हैं, वो जवाहरलाल नेहरू और चाइना के जो लीडरशिप, उनके नेतृत्व में चाउन लाई के द्वारा दोनों के बीच में हुए एक समझौते के तहत अपनाए गए थे. और जो पंचशील है, ये पांच सिद्धांत है जिसके अंतर्गत आ जाता है एक दूसरे की जो टेरिटोरियल इंटेग्रिटी है, भौगोलिक अखंडता और संप्रभुता है, उसके लिए पारस्परिक सम्मान, अनाक्रमण आ जाता है, एक दूसरे के आंतरिक मामलों में हस्तक्षेप ना करना आ जाता है, समानता और पारस्परिक लाभ आ जाता है, इसके साथ ही शांतिपूर्ण सह अस्तित्व और आर्थिक सहयोग आ जाता है. और जिसे बार बार नेहरू और टीटो और नासिर, इनके द्वारा बार बार दोहराया गया और काफ़ी ज़्यादा देशों के द्वारा इसे सपोर्ट किया गया. और आज जबकि हम लोग न्यूक्लियर वॉर, परमाणु जो युद्ध है या न्यूक्लियर वेपन से जुड़ कितने अधिक मात्रा में विश्व के देश अपने बार में संग्रहित कर चुके हैं और हम लोग कर रहे हैं, और हम लोग एक परमाणु युद्ध के दरवाजे पर खड़े हैं, उस वक्त जो पंचशील के सिद्धांत है यही हमारी और मानवता की रक्षा कर सकते हैं. जीव और जीने दो का जो सिद्धांत है, ये पंचशील का बेसिक सिद्धांत है, उसके नियम के रूप में कार्य करता है, और यही आज विश्व को इतनी ज़्यादा मुश्किलों से बचा भी सकता है. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे फ्रॉम माय साइड. थैंक यू वेरी मच.